Hello and good afternoon from Proactive New York. Joining me today from AMPD Ventures is Anthony Brown. Anthony, good to see you. How are you?
Doing very well, Christine. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks for asking. Anthony, lots to talk about today. I'm going to kick it off with asking you about the company's expansion of its Learning Factory digital twin partnership. Tell me exactly what this means for investors who are new to the story, new to this space.
Sure. Well, I think the first thing to do is to identify that this is a Canadian supercluster project and explain what the superclusters are. And then I'll get specifically into the Learning Factory Digital Twin project. So first of all, in Canada, we have a federally run program for superclusters being built all the way across Canada. The one in Vancouver is the Canadian Digital Technology Supercluster. And we were one of the founding members of that supercluster and currently have a seat on the board as well. And one of the first projects that they kicked off was the Learning Factory Digital Twin. So these are federally funded programs to help at Canada, advance from a technology perspective. And that's what the supercluster program is. Now, specifically, this Learning Factory Digital Twin project was built based on a consortium of AVCOR, AMPD, Lamazoo, Convergent and UBC, all working together to develop a digital twin of an aerospace manufacturing plant. So what a digital twin is might need a little bit of explanation as well. So the idea behind a digital twin is that you're able to not only capture all of the 3D objects and environments and so on in a full spatial 3D simulation, but then also to apply all of the intelligence behind it from IoT sensors, from various different feeds that will give you the background intelligence as to what's actually happening in the real world, and then display it in this digital twin, this virtual reality environment of the aerospace manufacturing plant in this case. And so what we're doing here, we already engaged in that project and completed the project as what was stated out, working with those folks to create the digital twin. The extension of the project is to actually be able to access that digital twin from anywhere with any device. And so we're working very closely with Lamazoo specifically around being able to take their software, which they call Clarity, and put it onto what we call our Cloud XR platform. So what Cloud XR stands for, XR is mixed reality. And the idea here is that you're able to be able to access this digital twin of the aerospace manufacturing plant without having to have a big beefy computer that's running the whole twin under your desk. You can access it with all of the computing actually happening off-prem on the AMP platform and just have almost any device connect to it and do so efficiently. And that's what we term as Cloud XR. And that's basically the extension of the project that we're looking at with Learning Factory Digital Twin, is to allow users to be able to log into Clarity, which is the software that Lamazoo built, to be able to see the digital twin, even with a full-on, VR headset, but just having a regular laptop or something like that to connect to it. And so it's an evolution of what we're seeing around the metaverse in being able to bring in real-world objects, real-world buildings, and so on, digital twins into a 3D environment, and then applying the real-time rendering of graphics to make it accessible from anywhere.
And for those who use the service, I would assume this would just cut down costs.
Oh, it cuts down costs immensely. As far as the extension is concerned, it cuts down costs immensely because you don't have to buy, big high-end computers to be able to access the digital twin. But in general, digital twinning applies across multiple industries. It's not just a matter of aerospace manufacturing. It's a matter of any kind of manufacturing, any kind of engineering, architecture, city planning. Digital twinning is a very useful tool for all of those sorts of disciplines. And so being able to efficiently do digital twinning or being able to create digital twins of real world things is a very key thing, not only to impact the industry. So, being able to have an architect take a walkthrough from the house and inside the house he's designed or inside the building he's designed and be able to tweak it. Imagine a digital twin of a human heart and being able to have a cardiologist stand in the middle of a human heart while it's pumping with all of the data that's involved in it. I mean, the applications are immense, but it's also kind of an underpinning of how we're going to bring real world objects into the metaverse in general.
And as you said, this kind of all just fits into your Cloud XR platform.
How we serve it up is based on the Cloud XR platform. So how it gets accessed by users from their house, their phone, their computer, their TV, is the Cloud XR platform. But there are, to actually create the digital twin and run all the simulations and intelligence and artificial intelligence algorithms and so on, that's another part of the platform. And that's more around our virtual studio product and our high performance compute architecture to be able to do all that calculation work, which is what we did for the first part of that project.
A lot to digest today, but as always, it's super interesting to talk to you. Anthony, thanks so much.
My pleasure.